station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Leah Cheshire. As Earthlings begin to prepare for holiday travel and traffic, the crew on orbit is expecting increased traffic in space, too. The SS John Young, Northrop Grumman's latest Cygnus commercial resupply spacecraft, will launch atop an Antares rocket, beginning its journey to the space station this weekend. Cygnus is carrying over 7,500 pounds of crew supplies, station hardware, and scientific research, including a new 3D printer and recycler to turn waste plastic materials into high-quality 3D printer filament. You can watch live coverage of the vehicle's launch, capture, and berthing upon its arrival. Find the schedule and watch live at nasa.gov/nasatv. Cygnus isn't the only spacecraft that's station-bound. The 71 Progress resupply craft is also scheduled for an upcoming journey with a destination of the station. The Russian resupply craft will launch from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan on Friday, November 16th. Progress is loaded with almost 6,000 pounds of food, fuel, and supplies. The spacecraft will arrive at the station 2 days later on November 18th and remain docked for 4 months before departing in March 2019. You can find the full schedule and watch Progress launch and docking by tuning in to live coverage on our website. This week's question is from Keith, who asks if the Soyuz crew capsule has a maximum on-orbit lifespan. Upon arrival to the International Space Station, the Russian Soyuz stays docked until it's time for the crew to return to Earth. The capsule has a 200-day orbital lifetime, meaning the crew must return home within that time frame. The current crew aboard the space station, a trio consisting of an American astronaut, European astronaut, and Russian cosmonaut, are scheduled to return to Earth in their Soyuz on December 19th. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag Space to Ground. We'll see you next week.